To regret is to feel sorry or disappointed or distressed about a choice that one can make. When a sense of loss comes in the heart of a person, it means that something is lost, something is gone. There is a regret, there is a cry. There is why did this happen? But deeply in the heart, we have to make a choice. In the book of Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 19, there's a choice that the Lord made for the Israelites. There's a choice that the Lord made when they were walking towards their new chosen land. This is the choice that the Lord made for them. Deuteronomy chapter 30 verse 19 says, I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you that, I repeat, I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you that I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore choose life that both you and your descendants may live. This was a choice that the Lord was making for the Israelites. Before them there was life and death, and before them as well there was blessing and curses. And they were told to choose life. In this life that we live, we regret over choices that we made, about things that happened later because of the choices we made. Maybe you made a choice of a wife or a husband, but later in your lifetime, you are regretting, why did they make this choice? Yeah. Amen. Whenever regret comes, it finds us when we have already made a choice. Regret comes after the choice. But all in all, the Lord still sent a son to help us redeem the time. Because some may regret maybe about a dinner you had. Afterwards, he brought some stomach ache. He said, I wish I wouldn't have eaten. I wish. The wish is a regret. A great regret not. So I want to say, the wisdom of making a right choice should be made in every individual in accordance to the life that you anticipate. To anticipate is to ile unaashiria ya kwamba utakuwa. The one that you anticipate. In life, even after we are married and we are continuing on in life, in the relationship that we are in, many people regret their whole life. They are always crying. No one's saying, why? How? What? These are every questions. These are all the questions that they are asking themselves. And I want to say, when you fill your hearts with regret, then it means you are not worshiping God. Yeah. Because of a choice you made, there came a regret. And now the regret is making your tears to fall down. When that happens, worship wanes away. You can't worship. You only worship the Lord when your heart is in line with God and there is something that you have There's some wisdom you have mixed with the choice that you have. Like right now, I may give you time to think whether to choose to worship. Yeah. Then now you have thought.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't want any mess. Amen. Put your meter. Amen. Like right now, I may say, choose now to worship. Then you choose. Maybe you chose to come. Good. Then now, when you are in, you choose to agree with me. That is a good choice. Then you choose that when I hear the word, it will be to my benefit. That's a good choice. Every choice that you make that you will never regret about is for the betterment of your Christendom. Your Christianity is about a thought in your life. When you think about it, you weigh it to or not. Amen?
Amen?
Amen? Yes. I'm talking about making a right choice. Making a right choice from the word go that you will never regret. Well, other choices you may choose because you have to, without which, even if regret comes later, we can still amend because the Son came to be nailed to the cross so that some things are washed away. Because there are some which are inevitable. You can't just say, I won't decide. Maybe not deciding, maybe even deciding to fail. Yeah, some choices you got to say. Okay, let me take an example. You are married, you are in your life, and then you have children. Then now the children that you have, you decide to love your business or your work than and neglect the children. When time comes that you are supposed to teach them something, you neglect that and say they are with their mother. Then later in life, they get into some shoddy deals, some bad things. Then now when you come back and find out that now you are supposed to caution them, you can't move to them. They can't hear you. Why? Because you neglected them sometime. So there's a regret that comes later. You say, I wish I knew. I wish I was with them earlier. I wish at that time that I had the prodding, I would have sat next to them. So in that regard, I will say this. Let us in our hearts, in the deepest of your heart, choose to go in line with what is written. Yeah, when we are parents, let us deal with the child cautiously and step by step. There is every time that they need this or that. There's a teaching time. Maybe even when the child does not come, you should pray so that when the child comes, you can give it a better stand from the word go, that this one will be for God. Yeah? Then when you start now nurturing and saying, this is that child that, Lord, I give you, then you will have a better standing and you will have also a grip of the child. Some children go out of hand. Why? Because you didn't grip early. When you don't grip early, you regret. Yeah, some people regret, say, I can't tell her anything. Whenever she has decided this way, you can't even talk to her. If you talk to her, she cries. Will it be that the tears will make you say that the child is better off, so she should just have her way because she shed tears? Yeah, God forbid. Let the tears not give a leeway that because of the tears now I let her do her will. She may fall off the course. Praise the name of the Lord. Yeah, I've just given that as an example. So I will say, regrets come because of choices that we say, this is the way, and that is it. So tears, let tears not cheat us. Yeah, because some are crocodile tears, so that other people can do their will. Yeah, tears are there. But they are genuine tears and the crocodile tears. Amen? See, I'm saying something. Yeah, somebody can just cry. Then all of a sudden, when you are away, then they do their thing. Then later, there's a regret that comes. Consequences come because of wrong choices. Amen? If there's somebody in the Bible known as Gehazi, Gehazi had a bad choice. In 2 Kings chapter 5, I don't want to read there. There's a story of Elisha saving Naaman, the king. And then when Naaman is bringing a gift, Elisha says, no, your gift I don't need. But Gehazi, being the handman to Elisha, goes behind the curtains and takes that. Then an apicon and leprosy. Yeah? You can make a bad choice and regret later. So there are choices that we make. We don't make that we are asleep. No, you are just all eyes. You make the choice, then you regret later. So I will say this day, as we are praying, engineer yourself to have a better choice. Ask God to give you a better choice. Ask God to give you a better choice. Just another choice, not the common choice. A choice that when you are in it, you will say, I think this is what God wants for me. Many choices that we make don't hit the mark. Why? Because we are so soulish. And you know, binafsi mingi, maifanya kivyako nasema, You may even choose to do something on your own, not knowing that it will affect everybody around you. Even a slight choice will affect your whole family. That they are part of you. When you have a loss, you are in grief. They are all in grief. Amen? When you lose something, they have all lost it because maybe it was for them that you had it. Amen? So, let us learn or vow or will or find it in our hearts to have a better choice. Let us rise on our feet. Miserable lives come because of bad choices. And when the choice is bad, there may be even some time that you can't change it. You'll have to find another negative thing to cover it and continue in that. Amen? Yeah, let us go before the Lord and tell Him that my choice may be right. Yeah. Shall sing. After singing, we shall go before the Lord. So that in this year, we may not make the wrong choices. Find it in your heart to love someone, to appreciate someone. Find it in your heart to be a welcomer this year. Yeah, find it in your heart not to be in regrets, living in shambles.
You are a father, and I think it is.
somebody make a right choice. Purpose in your heart to have a better choice. Father, we make a right choice today. Father, that my choice is for you, Lord. Every bad choice, oh Lord, that I have to about. Father, forgive me for the wrong choices that I've had. Forgive my ego for the wrong choices that I've had. That have kept me crying. I'm saying I wish I would. Father, of the wrong choices, oh my God, that I've done. Father, wash away every wrong choice in my life. Everything that I regret about, oh my God. Father, I regret everything of that sends me your God in life. Father, wash it away from me. Said in the word, oh my God, that I may choose life. Father, this day I call my life, Lord. To create life, Lord, in Jesus Christ. And it rained on earth. At the end of which, when the earth was submerged in the deluge, yes, the Lord regretted and he brought the rainbow as a regret. He saw as if his vision was not going to be fulfilled, and he said, never again shall he bring waters of that magnitude. Regret causes us to cry. Now I want you to go before the Lord. If there are any regrets in your mind, in your life, every regret, just ask God to forgive you for the wrong choices that you made. That the Lord may forgive you for every choice made that have brought many, many tears in your life. Come on, somebody, just go before the Lord. Father, of the regrets that you did regret, O Lord, only once. That you regretted, oh my God, because of the flood. Father, I pray that anything that has caused regrets, oh Lord, that this year, Lord God, may be a year, Lord, of healing. Every person that I have not forgiven, Lord, in my heart, that causes me to stagnate, that your answers may not reach me, Lord. Oh, Father, I release them off my heart.
We believe. Remember me, oh Lord, remember me.
over you as you make a good choice. As you make a choice, ask God to keep soberness in you. Yes, that the Lord may govern your thinking, that your thoughts may be aligned.
My God, be elevated. My God, be my strength.
in your past, maybe the reasons things are the way they are today.
But don't allow them
to become an excuse to stay that way.
The book of Numbers, chapter 21,
verse 5,
the Bible says,
Numbers 21, verse 5,
and the people spoke against God and against Moses. Why have you brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no food and no water, and our soul lopes.
I'll read again. Numbers 21, verse 5. And the people spoke against God and against Moses. Why have you brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no food and no water, and our soul loathes this worthless bread. Praise God. There was a time when God and Moses were blamed by the Israelites. I want to reflect in the things that we undergo. Maybe it reaches a time in your life when you blame the church, you blame your pastor, you blame your friends, you point a finger, you say, so and so didn't do this and that. You blame. There's a blame within you. You choose to blame. I want to tell us this day, I want to give us time to go before the Lord. If there is anything in your mind that is just chosen for you to blame a man of God, you blame. And when you blame it fully. It causes stagnation in life. Very many generations of the Israelites, some generations they didn't reach. Those that started didn't reach. Canaan. Yeah, they didn't reach. Some died. They died in their thousands. Why? Because of blaming in the wrong manner. I will say this day, let's just go before the Lord. If there is a point in time that you blamed man of God, you blamed the church because of some word that you are passing it today. Yeah, you are passing through something. You say, this I blame on the church. The church, because of the church, I'm this way. It may be something that brings stagnation. Yeah, let us stop making excuses. Don't make any excuse within you, but because no way. Just go before the Lord and release yourself. Repent if you can. In Jesus, let us go before the Lord. Lord, we have complaints of my mentors, Lord. People, Lord, who brought me to salvation. Yes, them that prayed for me, Lord God. Where, Lord, I lay some blame. Father, forgive me. Father, forgive me. Father, forgive me. In Jesus' mighty name, forgive me, Lord. Forgive me, Lord God, for any blame that I have for Lord. Every blame that I have for Lord God. That causes me to be the way I am. Forgive me, Lord. Forgive me, myself. If the situation that I'm in, oh my God, I've laid a blame for a man of God. Oh, Father, gorgeous, forgive me, myself. Compromising. I serve you, Lord. For unconditionally shall I do this. King, you are the Savior forever. You are the Master in our lives. You are the Lord that is good. You are the Lord that is great. Father, we thank you today. Bless us, Lord, even as we hear your word. You are the Savior that is, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Come, Jesus, we pray. Shema Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
Awesome, I love what you're doing. Thank you because of this morning. Thank you because of your power. Thank you because of your grace. I know, Jehovah Lord, that your visitation will prevail. Your anointing will prevail. Jehovah Lord will speak to us according to your will, and we shall be secure. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, though the sorrows may last for the night, your joy is coming in the morning. In Jesus' mighty name. Today you are visiting someone. In Jesus' name. You are touching someone. In Jesus' name. Your grace is manifesting. In Jesus' name. Oh, Jehovah Lord, with you we are secure. With you we'll troop through walls. With you we'll conquer. In Jesus' mighty name. Oh, Jehovah Lord, we welcome you here once again. I welcome you here once again. I welcome you here once again. May you prevail. May you prevail. May you prevail. In that sister's life. In that family's life. May you prevail. May you prevail. May you prevail. We want to see you, dear Lord. Makose de teso monoli mekeso monoli. Thank you, Jesus, we are praying. And in the mighty name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may be seated. Tell your neighbor, in your hands, I commit my life.
In your